Hey guys, after not posting a video for like a month, I'm finally back with another problem to do. So this is a problem from statistics. It's giving us a PDF and asking us to obtain the maximum likelihood estimator for beta, and we're calling it beta hat. So we're basically doing MLE or maximum likelihood estimation by hand. I just got out of finals from the fall semester, so I've been doing these problems like a million times. And for me, it's pretty automatic. So I don't even know if I'm going to explain it very well, but I'll try. So the steps for these types of problems are pretty much always the same. Basically, we're given the PDF, and what we're going to do is take the product of the PDF. So this is the pi is the symbol for just multiplying the function by itself multiple times. And then to make the calculation simpler, we're going to take the natural log of that likelihood function, and that makes it easier if we're calculating it by hand like we are in this problem. And then you take the partial derivative with respect to whatever parameter you're trying to estimate. So in this case, it's going to be partial of the likelihood function, partial beta, and we set that equal to zero. And then you basically solve for beta, and whatever the solution is your maximum likelihood estimate. So this is the Weibull distribution, or however you pronounce it, and it has a couple different things in it, so I think it's a good example for finding maximum likelihood estimations. Okay, so let's go ahead and get started. So like I said, the first thing you do is you're going to take the product on both sides. So we're taking the product of this whole right side, which is the PDF. So let me just write that out to be thorough, and then go ahead and simplify this before you go on to the next step. So beta times beta times beta is going to be beta to the n. Same thing with the delta. So these, in this case, constants are going to be just to the n. For this thing, we're not going to be able to simplify it. So in parentheses, I'm just going to put pi x delta minus 1. And then for this part of the PDF, we're going to, when you take the product of that, it's going to be adding the variable part. So it's going to be e to the negative beta times the sum of x to the delta. And that's because e to the x times e to the x times e to the x multiple times is just e to the sum of the x's. All right, so now that we've done that, the next step is we're going to take the natural log of the likelihood function. So I usually just write it like that. And I'm going to combine, I guess, two steps in one because the natural log of beta to the n is equal to n times the natural log of beta. So I'm just going ahead and do those steps together. So this part changes to n ln beta. And then if you multiply natural logs, that's the same as adding them. So this is going to be plus the natural log of this part, which is going to simplify as n ln delta. And then this part is going to change. You can bring this part down, so that's going to be delta minus 1 times the sum of ln x. So that's kind of combining a couple of steps together. Hopefully that makes sense, the transition from one to the other. And then if you take the natural log of e, that's just going to cancel out. So we're going to have minus beta sum of x to the delta. All right, and then our next step is to take the partial derivative on both sides with respect to the population parameter we're trying to estimate. So that's beta in this case. So for this expression, we only care about taking the partial derivative with respect to beta. So anything that doesn't have beta is going to cancel out as zero, basically. So for this part of the problem, this is going to be n over beta when we take the partial derivative. So that's done. This does not have a beta term in it, so it's going to, the derivative is going to be zero. This also does not have beta in it, so this cancels out to zero. And this has a beta, so the partial derivative of that is negative the sum of x to the delta. And we set the partial derivative equal to 0, and now we're just going to solve for beta. So this is our beta hat estimate. So this is equal to n over beta hat equal to this negative term, which we're just bringing to the other side of the equal sign. So that's going to be equal to the sum of x to the delta. And then basically we're swapping this, so we multiply by beta hat and divide by the sum of x to the delta to get beta hat is equal to n over the sum of x to the delta. And that's our final answer for the maximum likelihood estimate of this distribution. And we're done with this problem.